Good evening. Thanks for joining us tonight. Emails went out today to rideshare customers that Lyft is leaving Minneapolis. Uber and Lyft both saying they're pulling out of the city over a new ordinance giving drivers a pay raise.
And right now, local agencies are scrambling, trying to figure out how to keep providing transportation to the area's most vulnerable residents. Jennifer Hoff joins us now with more on the big impact this is having. Jennifer?
Lauren, it's one leaders in nonprofit call a traumatic domino effect, especially on seniors and people with disabilities who rely on ride sharing.
Liz Workman and her daughter Tori may lean on each other for many things. Transportation isn't one of them.
She doesn't have to have me drive her.
Thanks to a unique partnership between Lyft and Dakota County that provides discounted rides to people with disabilities.
I use it quite often. I go to and from work.
Except on May 1st, Lyft announced it will stop serving Minneapolis, and Uber plans to leave the whole metro, putting thousands of people in peril.
They have to fix this.
The move comes after the city council voted to give drivers a boost in pay after they argued the companies keep cutting their wages. Mayor Jacob Frey, though, vetoed it, which the members would then override just yesterday, saying it's choosing workers over corporate greed. Uber and Lyft say fewer riders are now able to afford the service, making operations unsustainable.
So right now, our biggest focus is communication.
Sherry Wagner heads up Connectability of Minnesota, a nonprofit coordinating services for people, including 3,000 of them, she says, uses Lyft, a partnership that started 4 years ago, who now need to know what happens next.
They are literally going to have to quit their jobs because they will have no transportation to get to them.
Leading to limited access to housing, food, and appointments, creating an isolating effect and demand on social services. Wagner commending the council for approving a livable wage, but questioning the cost.
They stuck to their guns on their highest price, and now everybody else has to pay the price for that.
Wagner says her clients will have to rely more on cab companies and Metro Transit. Even if her clients can use the rideshare companies, it would mean more bus transfers and a higher cost to just skirt around the city that, of course, will be blacked out. So more barriers, some say, that only further impacts the freedom of mobility. Julie? All right. Thank